Looking for a way to get healthy? The Chef You and I program has the answer. Kathryn Raaker and chefs from around the nation will teach even the most inexperienced how to cook. Come into their kitchen and watch them take ordinary foods with loads of calories and fat and turn those foods into healthier dishes. You will be the first to get tips and ideas on foods that are easy to prepare. Now let's join Kathryn and today's chef and learn how to make today's recipes.
Hi, this is Kathryn Raaker, and our chef today is Celeste Fuller, and she is probably one of my best new friends.
Yes.
She is a patient consultant with NxStage,
yes,
hemodialysis and NxStage dialysis, and also he has been a dialysis patient. So what we're doing, the next couple of shows that we're doing actually are on what a dialysis patient should be eating. And this is for Thanksgiving. So it's a very special meal, right?
Exactly.
Extremely wonderful meal. And the first thing that we're making is what? A rustic apple?
We're going to make a rustic apple cinnamon phyllo dough pastry.
Yeah, so it's almost like a little pie or a muffin.
Exactly.
That we're going to do, and we're going to do it in that muffin tin. So can you tell us what the ingredients are so that we can start working on this? Because we got a lot to do tonight.
Oh, yes, we do.
Go ahead.
The ingredients include an apple mixture,
uh-huh,
meaning that you can use 4 apples that are Granny Smith or Gala apples, any apple that you really
right.
like.
And I'm chopping those apples up right now.
And what we're going to do first is we're going to saute those in some butter.
Ooh, that sounds good.
For about 6 to 8 minutes.
All right.
This is a really easy recipe.
Right.
The benefit is that you won't have those after holiday blues with your dietitian. You'll be able to still be in compliance and enjoy the meal with your family.
So what are the things that we have to watch for as a dialysis patient? Not a lot of phosphorus, right?
Well, that's primarily one of the culprits of holiday season.
Really?
Is phosphorus.
Really?
And the other, of course, would be sodium.
Okay, so what we're going to do this is we're going to put this butter in, and that's 1/4 cup.
And what we did is we used unsalted butter.
Unsalted butter, that's what we did. And we're going to put this in, all of it, actually.
Yes. That's 4 apples
four
of your choice.
4 apples of your choice that we did, already cut up.
Mm-hmm.
And they're going to get nice and soft.
Nice and soft and caramely.
Caramely,
yes.
Right. So, just one more here.
It should satisfy that sweet taste without getting you in trouble.
Right. So, what we need to do is put the top on, right?
Exactly.
What? Right here. We're going to do this. All right. And that looks really good. Okay, so just give me the top.
Yes.
Okay. We'll put the top on it.
Absolutely.
And now what are we going to do next? Tell me what's next.
The next step that we're going to do,
mm-hmm,
is we're going to get ready to prepare to make what we will add to the apples.
Right.
And that's going to include cinnamon, nutmeg, and brown sugar.
Okay, so
mixed
how much do I need of the cinnamon?
Okay, we need one teaspoon of cinnamon.
Which is right here.
Mm-hmm.
1 teaspoon.
We need 1/4 teaspoon of nutmeg.
I love nutmeg,
oh
don't
gosh.
You?
So
good.
It just speaks of the holiday season.
Yeah,
I
love it. I love it.
Just luscious.
When I'm making my Reis, I'm always doing something in the oven, so it smells good.
It smells
okay,
so good.
Then what?
And the last thing that we're going to add is some brown sugar.
Which we've already pre-measured right here. And how much
is
this?
It's 1/4 cup.
That's 1/4 cup. All right, so we need to mix that.
We're going to just mix that together.
Right. Easily.
And kind of just set it aside.
Uh-huh.
Because once again, our apples are sauteing in the butter for 6 to 8 minutes.
Right.
And then we'll add our mixture for 3 to 4 additional minutes.
Oh, okay. That'll be really good. Those will be really sweet. But
absolutely,
not so sweet that it's not doing harm to you, right?
Exactly. Exactly.
I noticed that on the dialysis diet, the diabetics can do it too.
Yes. Yes. You know, it's about moderation,
uh-huh,
and because we are so individual, We're gonna put it's that about aside. Doing those things, you uh-huh. working with your dietitian
right.
to stay in compliance.
Right.
It just pays. My nightmare used to be ham because of the
really?
High sodium
oh,
and
wow.
the high phosphorus.
Really?
And so it would take days and days to get uh-huh. the fluid off
right.
when I was on dialysis. So I just don't do ham as much
yeah.
anymore.
Well, ham, you know, my husband loves ham, but it does have a lot of sodium in it. Even if it's light in sodium.
Yes.
Okay, so now what else do you want me to do?
Okay, in the next step, what we need to do is in a small cup, we're mm-hmm. going to mix cornstarch and vanilla.
Well, I've already got the cup.
Okay.
And I need to do a quarter of a
What you're
going to
do is you're going to do a quarter teaspoon
mm-hmm.
of cornstarch.
See, mixed there
with
it is.
Exactly.
That's
and
not very much.
And just give that a little whisk, and
okay.
there you go. It's just going to act as our thickener.
Right, which will be really good. I use cornstarch in a lot of stuff that I do.
Yes, yes.
Okay. So we got that done.
Okay.
Now what?
A lot of it is going to be just kind of waiting from here.
Uh-huh.
We're waiting for our 6 to 8 minutes.
What are we doing with
that?
This now, then?
Okay, then what we're going to do with this is actually our powdered sugar.
Our powdered sugar.
That we're going to use with our pastry.
Okay.
The pastry dough.
Okay.
And what we're going to do first is we're going to baste it with some melted butter.
Uh-huh.
And then we're going to then dust it.
Dust it with powdered sugar?
Powdered sugar and cinnamon.
Oh, that sounds like fun.
That's it.
Okay, so I'll clear this off for that, or whatever you're going to do right there, right?
Right, exactly.
Because I don't think I need any of this stuff anymore. Right. And we need to move the bagwell out for a minute.
Yes.
You don't need that. We don't need this any longer.
Sure
I don't
think.
Here's
the top.
Here's the top for it.
Here's the
and
vanilla.
So you don't have to sit in dialysis centers anymore, do you?
No, I was really fortunate to get a transplant
yeah.
on June the 3rd of this
year. Right.
So I am just excited with that.
Oh,
but
yeah.
I'll tell you, I was on NxStage home hemodialysis for about 6 years. So most of these diets I'm already used to. And I'll tell you, I have learned that compliance is not that difficult.
Really?
It really isn't that difficult.
And that's what we're teaching people,
exactly.
right? Is to be compliant.
Exactly.
So that's important to know.
Compliance actually will translate into choice.
Yeah.
It's a lot easier to make your choices and modality when you have been more compliant.
Okay. So what we could be doing is those, right?
Yes. What we need to do with these, this is our phyllo dough.
Mm-hmm.
Phyllo dough.
Mm-hmm. And we need to use a pastry brush. And
yes.
I'm going to wipe this off for a minute. And, you know, I really, really, we've had a lot of fun together in the last couple of weeks.
Oh, yes.
Since you were on our show. About your life story, right?
Yes.
So, I love working with phyllo dough. It's so much fun.
Oh, my gosh.
Actually, it's so dry. So, the idea is to get it done really quick.
Exactly.
So, do you want me to help you do this?
Yes, if you don't mind.
Okay, I don't mind.
Okay, well, what we're going to do is we're
right.
going to separate the sheets. There's
right.
6 sheets.
Right.
And what we're going to do is we're going to baste it with
the butter.
Butter.
And then it goes directly in there, correct?
In the back. And what we've already done with our pan is we've just lightly greased it. We used a Pam
mm-hmm.
Spray
mm-hmm.
to just lightly grease it so that they'll pop right out.
Okay, so then can me a couple sheets and I'll
okay.
do it. Because you got two of them over there, right? You got
yes,
another
I do.
One. All right, so let's do go. This. So where's the other pastry brush?
I just slipped it right
you did?
Here.
Okay. All right,
and
so if you want to share it with me, we
yes,
can do that.
Yes, I do.
So what we're going to do is just go like this.
Yep.
Easily.
Yep, nothing
and
big.
It's just like painting,
exactly.
right?
Exactly.
And you're a painter.
Yes, I am.
And
I really enjoy painting.
Tell me what you do for fun. You do.
Well, I'll tell you, having been on dialysis for the length of time that I have been,
mm-hmm.
I am a crafter. And,
yeah.
And it's just easier to say I'm a crafter because if I can learn it, I'll do anything.
Now you turn these over,
yes,
right?
Yes, turn it over and do the other side.
Right. Okay, let's move.
My latest venture is furniture
what?
Painting.
Furniture painting?
Yes.
Oh, I need a lot of furniture painting done. I'm serious. We have stuff upstairs that you have to be really careful with these because they tear so easily.
Yes, they do.
You know, and I make baklava all the time.
Oh,
I love it.
Oh.
And even if it does tear on this, don't worry about it because guess what?
It's going to be
put in that little thing. So how many do you put in there at one time?
Six.
Six in one little thing?
What we're going to do is we're going to cut it into smaller pieces.
Okay.
And they'll
is that the first
right
thing we're
in.
Doing?
That's going to be the first thing that we're doing.
So we are going to cut it with a knife or scissors.
With the first sheet, brush each side with melted butter. And then what we do is we dust it with the...
Oh, dust it with...
our brown sugar and our cinnamon.
So we need actually to take a little short break. We're back, and I'm doing the last sheet with the dusting, okay? And then we're going to cut it. Will you cut it for me?
Yes.
Into six different pieces, and then it's going to go into the muffin tin, right?
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
All we've done is we've, on both sides, we've basted basted the dough.
Right.
With butter.
Right.
And then sprinkled a mixture of the powdered sugar.
Right.
And the
So what you want to do next is you're going to take this and put it here, but I think you need to move this other phyllo. Oh, so roll that back up, and you can use the phyllo. We'll put it in the refrigerator, and we'll wrap it up. Okay, so then do this, and then do you want me to get a spatula? No, you don't need one?
I don't think we need one.
Okay, so now what are you going to do?
And what we're going to do is we're going to lay it just right into
the center.
Of our muffin pan.
Right.
Just like that.
And then we're going to add the apples to that. And then we'll bake it in the oven at 375 degrees.
Yes.
Correct?
Yep. What we're going to do is we're going to make sure that the cinnamon is nice and...
Here you go.
On your apples.
Okay. Here.
Thank you.
Here you go. I mean, we put seven on here, so in case anything would happen, we would have it.
And plus, we like it nice and flaky.
Yeah, we do want it flaky. Lots of flake.
Lots of flake.
Right. And this is easy. You could do this with your children or grandchildren. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this off for a minute and put it back here so I can add the other wonderful things that we're going to add to it, which is... the brown sugar mix?
Yes.
All right. You want to do that. That's going to be really good.
Nice and hot. Tasty.
Nice and hot. And hold on. I want to move this a minute. Hold on. And I go like that. Because then it's got the butter. And where's the other butter? You've got... Do we have other butter to put in here or not?
No, there's no more butter needed, which is a really great thing. Cut down on your fat.
That's right.
Keep you from having problems with the cholesterol.
Right. And this is ready to go, actually. Do you want to give it to me and I'll just spoon it in? Whoops. That's good. Get a little bit more there. Right?
Yes.
That looks really delicious.
And it smells even better.
Mm. I don't know. I think I'd want to put some ice cream or something.
I was thinking some golden raisins.
Oh, that sounds good. Here. I'll add some more there in a minute. Mm-hmm. I just want to make sure we got enough. Right?
Yeah.
There's some here. And this is really... all of these recipes will be up on the... They're on the NxStage site, right?
Yes.
But they're also on the Kathryn Raaker site, too. Which is the Chef You and I, and I'll eat a little bit more there. Which one? Here?
One of the things that we've tried to do is to choose recipes that are not only tasty, but easy for us to prepare after a dialysis treatment or in preparation before you'd have to go to dialysis, because a lot of times during the holiday, our schedules may not change, but we still want to participate in the activities with our families. And so recipes that we can do that are quick and easy
there you
and
go.
Also healthy are great for us.
And then we can put these in the oven, and we'll be right back on The Chef You and I with myself, Kathryn Raaker, and Celeste Fuller of NxStage, patient advocate and consultant. We'll be right back. We're back now and on The Chef You and I with Kathryn Raaker and Celeste Fuller. And actually, we wanted you to see these beautiful, wonderful, they are
phyllo dough.
The rustic apple phyllo dough.
Cinnamon.
Cinnamon apples.
Yes.
And so we're going to do the rub for this. So you're going to use actually a cup of... Oh, and look at how big those are.
I know.
They're huge.
I know. They're huge. And believe it or not, it is one turkey wing per person, including the dialysis patients.
Right.
So you'll be able to eat right along with your family. Many people don't like the other cuts, but this is easy.
It's easy, and you can cut it apart and get a lot of meat out of it.
Absolutely.
So I need you to tell me what we're going to do.
So what we've already done is we've washed the wings off, and we patted them dry.
Right.
Pierced them with a fork so that the marinade won't penetrate.
We'll go into it.
We're going to rub them liberally with the rub that you have made.
So I'm making it with 1 cup of dark brown sugar.
That's right.
Okay.
And the next thing that you're going to do is you're going to add a teaspoon of black pepper.
All right. So what I do when I do things like this is I put a little bit of extra in here and then I measure it into it.
Absolutely.
So there's a lot of spices in this, so be careful. And then we have already pre-measured the
red pepper flakes.
And then paprika.
1 teaspoon of red pepper flakes. It takes 1 teaspoon of smoked paprika.
And if you've never used smoked paprika, it's really good stuff.
Oh, it smells so good.
It is good. So 1 teaspoon. Okay, then what?
The next thing that we're going to do is we're going to use some onion, chopped onion.
Flakes.
Dried chopped onions.
And how much?
And what we're going to do is we're going to use 2 teaspoons of that.
2 teaspoons.
As well.
And that's really not much.
No, it isn't.
Actually.
Now, the recipe also does call for garlic, but anybody that knows Kathryn knows that Kathryn does not do garlic. So we always go over that.
Okay.
I myself love garlic.
Do you want garlic in this?
No.
Okay. All right. So that now what?
The next thing that we're going to do is do 2 teaspoons of the dark chili powder.
Oh, it's right here.
Yes.
So there's a lot of spices in here. What?
Yes. And all of those flavors
really help.
Really help.
People that are definitely, that have dialysis, because sometimes they don't get to taste things like we do.
And
sometimes,
if you notice, we didn't put any salt in here at all.
No salt. But listen, when you put all these spices in, you won't miss a salt.
Not at all.
Right. So we're going to mix this together.
Mix that all together.
Right.
And the last thing that we're going to do is we have a low sodium barbecue sauce. And what we're going to do is we're going to use 2 tablespoons
per
wing.
So we have
four wings, we're going to do 8 tablespoons.
Right.
So. The entire recipe can be altered depending on that, depending on how many people you plan to serve.
Oops, sorry about that. 1.
Yes.
That was kind of messy. 2.
Happens.
3. How much?
8.
4. 5. 6. 7. 8.
Absolutely.
That's good.
Yes.
Right?
And we're going to mix that together.
Right.
And then kind of reserve a little bit so that you can baste them later on as they're baking.
Right. That's really good. And it's easy to do. And actually, we've tried this recipe before. Right? And I'm going to wipe this off with this. Hold on. Okay. Great. And it looks almost like chocolate cake when you're making it. It's
really
cute. Absolutely.
But it
did
is
we put the pepper
so
in?
Aromatic.
Yeah,
it is so aromatic.
It is. The barbecue sauce on here is Unbelievable. Mm-hmm. So now what we're going to do is we're going to actually put the rub on the wings.
Absolutely.
And we're going to take a little short break here for a second, because what we're going to do is we're going to put some aluminum foil down.
Yes.
And we're going to put the wings, we're going to actually baste the wings and put them into the pan, right?
Yep. Exactly.
Okay, let's do that. We're back, and we're now basting our turkey wings with the rub and barbecue sauce that we came. And so we want you to see this, so let's do it. All right. Just put them on there really good. You want to get it on there nice, because they become a nice, pretty color in the end, right?
Yes. And if you notice, all we did was we just rinsed the turkey wings off.
Right.
And the seasoning is just the rub. No salt, pepper, or anything else added.
And it's kind of like very fluidy. It's not like a rub like that you're used to.
A dry rub.
This is a wet rub. So what we're going to do is I'm going to turn this over and do it on both sides. And then you want the first half an hour that you bake these. And you know what? Seriously, when they're this big, I would say give it 40 minutes.
Yeah.
What do you think?
I think so. Amazingly, it is done at that time. But if you like your skin to be just a teeny bit crispier,
yes,
you could give it a few more minutes.
Yeah, a few more minutes. All right. So I think what we can do now is put this one onto the, well, wait a minute. Okay, I'm going to flip it over. Get that out of the way.
Sometimes I kind
of... Yeah, it's really amazing what they turn out like. They're really beautiful when they come out of the oven. We've done this before, so...
I'm going to just lay my first one right on the baking sheet.
Okay.
We'll rearrange them afterwards to make them all fit.
Right. Okay, so we need to take and put this one on. You do yours first, and then we'll move it over and put it in there.
I guess I like to baste generously, because it's the sweet, the sauce is so sweet and savory.
Yeah.
It's just so good.
I know, it's good. And a lot of people love wings. I love chicken wings. I'm just, as you know, I'm not a real turkey girl. So that's not one of my favorite things in the world, but that's fine.
I know. I love it.
I know you love it. So that's why we're doing it.
Yes. And it's just a real traditional
kind of thing
and easy for me as a patient. I was a patient and a mom and... You know, like to have my family over. It was always easiest for me, because I could be tired if I had to be.
Yeah, but you could do it easily.
Right, I could do it easily. I could
and
even
actually,
do it the day before.
We have a thing like here. Watch. I forgot all about it.
There we go.
So, and then all you have to do is, wait a minute, go like that, and then bring it over.
Yes.
Like that, right?
Yes.
And then if you could move them down a little. We need to move this down. Okay. Like that. All right.
Yeah.
Move this one over a little.
Yep.
And then let's move this over here.
Okay.
All right. And now we're gonna put this into a 350 degree oven. But we're gonna put it, before we do that, we're gonna cover it. And excuse me.
What we're gonna do is cover it and kind of make a pouch out of it so that it can steam as it cooks, which will make the meat much more tender.
And let's turn this around. And
no muss,
no fuss. It's done.
It's done.
So we'll put that in the oven and we'll be right back. We're going to take a short break and we'll be right back after that on Kathryn Raaker's The Chef, you and I. We're back on The Chef, You and I, with Celeste and Kathryn. And what we're doing is we're making the actual topping that goes onto our pork. So it's what?
We are making our topping, which is an actual glaze.
A glaze.
And it's a marmalade glaze.
Right.
And we're making it primarily because some people don't care for turkey. Just
That's
something
right.
a little
like
twisted.
Like Kathryn.
Yes, like Kathryn.
Right.
Some people don't really care for that. So what we're doing is we're making what they call a cherry marmalade glaze.
Glaze. Okay, so what do I need first, girl?
The first thing that you're going to need is your orange marmalade.
Okay,
We've
so it's right
put
here.
It
it's right here.
That's right. We have a half a cup.
And we've already pre-measured everything to make it easy. And this is sugar-free.
Yes.
Orange marmalade.
Yes.
Then what?
The next step is we have a quarter cup of apple juice.
Which we've already done here. Okay.
Then to that we're going to add some dried cherries.
Which you can get at the store very easily, right?
That's right.
And they're delicious.
And we have an eighth of both nutmeg and cinnamon.
An eighth?
An eighth of a teaspoon of both nutmeg and cinnamon.
Uh-huh.
Just a tad.
Just a tad. That's right. Oh, I can smell that nutmeg. Mm-hmm. Woo!
Mm-hmm.
All right. I don't need pepper, do
no,
I?
No pepper for this part.
All right. Okay, so you're going to mix that together. Just like that.
Mm-hmm.
And then we're going to cook this on the stove for how long?
Oh, you're going to cook it until it's warm and it starts to soften. The cherries will start to soften.
Okay.
There's no real time because it's something that we're going to use as a glaze later
right.
on.
So we're going to do that right now, right?
That's right.
Okay,
go
so we're going to come over here to the stove. And I'm going to move those tasty little wonderful pieces.
We've done well so far not to taste the pastry.
Right. Hold on. So let's talk about what we're doing here.
Well, as we're doing our marmalade glaze, one of the things that we're going to be sure of is that we don't burn it. So it's
right.
just on a low fire, just
right.
simmering, just bubbling just a tad.
You want to stir it, though.
Yes, you definitely want to stir
it.
It because
will
there's a lot of
stick
sugar
to the bottom
in there.
Of the hand.
Yes.
All right.
It smells tasty.
Oh, it is
so
actually...
good.
We had some of this earlier, and it was so delicious.
Oh, yes.
So what are we going to do next? You're going to make the stuffing next, or
yes.
am I going to make the stuffing next?
I'll make the stuffing.
You make the stuffing.
I'm going to make
the stuffing. So we'll just take a little break, and we'll get the stuffing together. And it's right there, so we just need a bowl. Hold on.
Okay.
Here's your bowl.
Thank you.
You want to do it right here while I'm... stirring, you can use mine.
Yes, that'll
okay,
be great.
Okay, right there.
This is called our apple stuffing. And to it, what we're going to do is we're going to add 2 tablespoons of canola oil. Since we happen to have some in the pantry, we're going to just measure the end right here. 1 and 2.
Okay, so they can give that to me and I'll take it away from you. Go ahead.
What I'm doing is I'm cutting 2 Hawaiian rolls into cubes, making our stuffing homemade. Just cutting it into 4s and then 4s again. Not going to think too much about it. Really simple Hawaiian rolls. You can get at just about any store and they're tasty all by themselves. So we're limiting ourselves, because of the amount of sugar, limiting ourselves to just 2, but it's going to be more than enough for our pork loin.
Oh, I will. We're going to put it right here for you.
Thank you.
You're welcome. And this is on so low, so I'm not burning it or anything. It's just getting beautiful, actually.
So I'm going to take my cubed Hawaiian rolls
uh-huh.
straight into the bowl.
Right.
The next thing I'm going to do is I have half a cup of Granny Smith apples.
Okay.
I'm going to just toss them in as well.
Okay, I can do that for you.
Thank you. Then we have unsalted butter, 2 tablespoons.
Oops! That's all right. Things happen. Thanks. And the butter was really soft, too, on top of it, which makes it really nice. There.
Then we have... our diced onions, 2 tablespoons of diced onions.
Okay.
If you would add those. The same 2 tablespoons of celery.
Mm-hmm. And?
And then we have some thyme. And this is 1 tablespoon of thyme.
Yeah, we've
fresh.
Already done, we've already done that. We've already, and that's fresh thyme.
Yes.
And then you're.
And then you want to mix those together.
Okay. All right. Mix those together. And don't you want to put the,
You know, I've cooked it both ways with the chicken stock already in it and also adding it a little bit at a time.
Yeah.
Depending on how you like your stuffing,
right.
You may choose to just go ahead and add it all at one time. It leaves it nice and moist and you're done. Or you may decide that you'd want to just saute it a little bit and just add as you need it so that your stuffing can be as dry or moist as you like.
I like my stuffing a little drier.
Do you?
Yeah.
Okay.
Because I think it gets too wet when you saute it.
Okay.
I think this could be just as nice doing it this way because
okay.
It's going to bake for like 45 minutes.
45 minutes. So
yeah.
Do you want to go ahead and add
yeah.
the...
Yeah, let's
okay.
add that.
Let's do this.
Let's
this
do
is
it.
2 cups. I think it's 2 cups.
I don't think it's 2 cups.
Half a cup.
Half a cup.
Of chicken stock.
Right.
So low sodium.
And if you wanted to, you could even add more of your bread to it if you wanted to not have it be so... juicy.
Yes.
Right? So.
But what we're going to do is we're going to saute that, and
okay.
that's going to brown it up some.
Yeah.
And we'll prepare our meat to
okay.
receive the stuffing.
We'll do that, and we'll be right back after these messages. I'm Kathryn Raaker, the Chef You and I. We're back on The Chef, You and I, and Celeste, we've already done the stuffing.
Right.
It's ready to be put into the pork. So if you could go ahead and do that first.
Okay, what I've done is our pork loin came with 2 pieces of pork, and yours will probably come the same. So what we've done is we've split it down, 1 piece down the middle, and we're just going to lay the dressing directly into the cavity that we've created.
And if there's extra, you can put it around the pan its
absolutely.
Edge.
You, it never goes to waste.
Never goes to waste. And then what we're going to do is we're going to put it into, you can either use regular twine, or I had the butcher cut this for me, and it'll go right into your oven, which is really fun. All right, so what you have to do is you have to have 1 person, actually this
is a definite 2-person job.
It really is. Okay.
Get it started.
I got to get it started. You got to get it on the bottom. Okay. And then you guide it. Whoops. And then I have to help her here as we do this. Can you pull it up a little?
Yes.
Okay. You have to guide it. All right. We're getting there.
Yes.
Okay.
It's a messy job.
Well, it's kind of messy.
But the thing is that all of the dressing.
Oh, yeah.
All of the dressing.
Right.
That
it's gonna
falls
stay
off.
We'll go.
We can try to push into the center, back into
all
the
right.
center. It's not a neat job, but it's a delicious job.
Okay. I'm getting it. It's coming. Watch it.
There we go.
Yeah, and then we can use that extra, we can do that extra, right?
Yeah.
On the end of it, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Do you have enough? Here.
I can use just a teeny bit more.
All right.
As I push
or
it.
Or you can use the twine. Okay, is that enough now?
Yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So then you're just going to fold this over, right?
Yeah.
Got it?
Got it.
Okay, so then you want to take it and put it into a dish like that, right? And then what you could do is you could take this and put it right there. It won't hurt it, right?
Not
like that.
Bit.
Okay, and then we're going to put it into a 400-degree oven.
Yes.
And we're going to, you want to put your thermometer in and you wanted to come up to 160 degrees. And
absolutely.
Then you know that your pork is done, but you don't want it overdone either. All right.
That's right.
We're going to take a little break so that we can clean up a little so we can go on to our next recipe. We'll be right back. We're back on the Chef You and I, and we're making an orzo, right? Lemon orzo spring salad. That's what it's called. So we've already pre-made the orzo.
Yes.
So what we're going to do, and we've already cut up all of our vegetables to make it easy for all of you. So, and we've measured them. She's going to give you the ingredients. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take 2 tablespoons of olive oil, correct?
That's right.
And I am going to saute the vegetables that you're going to hand me.
Okay.
Okay. And I need this right here. And we're going to heat this up.
This is 3/4 cup of orzo already ready to go. So the only thing that we're going to need to do is to saute our peppers. I've already cut the green peppers, and the green peppers are 1/4 cup of fresh green peppers.
All right, thank you. And I love these little baggies. It makes it so easy when you want to chop up your... Prepare ahead of time.
That's 1/4 cup of yellow peppers.
Great. This is really colorful, actually.
1/4 cup of red peppers.
Okay. And what else?
We have 1/2 cup of onions.
Oh, yeah.
Chopped.
And that's a sweet onion, by the way.
Yes. You can use red or you can use the Vidalia.
Right.
Sweet. It's up to you.
Okay. And you just want to get this tender enough. You want to get a little, what's that right there?
I have some zucchini.
Oh, you got to put that zucchini
yes,
in there, girl.
It's 2 cups.
2 cups of zucchini.
Zucchini.
And I think we can get a picture with our camera here in a minute.
Yes.
So you can see how beautiful this is. Well, we'll show it in just a minute. Because you're not going to cook this very long.
No, you're just...
You want to get it all dente. Them?
Absolutely. Yeah. Just letting the flavors come alive.
Right.
Just wilting them just a teeny bit.
Right. And so what you're going to do now is you're going to put together the... Parmesan cheese?
Yes, I am.
And the lemon juice, I think you've got?
Yes. Right? What I'm going to do next is going to be part of the same dish, but it's just the second step. And what I've done is I have 1 cup of the lemon juice. Well, 3 tablespoons. To be exact, it might be just a teeny bit more because we did use fresh lemons. My suggestion is to always use as fresh as you can.
Don't forget the lemon zest.
I promise. I have it.
You got it?
This is our lemon zest. We're going to go ahead and add our 1/4 teaspoon of our lemon zest.
Well, that looks good.
Can you smell it?
Mm-hmm.
Doesn't it smell good?
It smells great.
And lastly, we're going to add 3 tablespoons of Parmesan cheese.
This smells so good.
I just need...
Here, just use a regular tablespoon.
That
won't hurt. It's a tablespoon.
Yeah. Goes right all in the bowl.
This is just about done. I can smell that it's almost done.
Oh my goodness. The next thing that I'm going to add is some thyme. We're using fresh thyme. And what we're doing, I'm sorry, fresh rosemary. And what we're doing is we're using 2 tablespoons of fresh rosemary.
And rosemary's beautiful.
Smell that.
I love rosemary.
So good.
Love rosemary.
And that's one of the things about this salad, the freshness, the different flavors all blending together are perfect for a dialysis diet. You'll taste it. Your taste buds will just enjoy that.
Well, we've turned it off.
And you'll still be compliant. So we've turned the sauteed materials off. Right. Okay. What we've done is we've added all of the ingredients. I've added also a half a teaspoon of red pepper flakes. I'm adding half a teaspoon of fresh oregano. And I'm adding another half a teaspoon of the black pepper, just straight black pepper. We're doing a little estimating. We like it spicy.
Yeah, I know.
And after that, this salad is so simple that what you're going to do now is go ahead and add your sauteed vegetables.
All the sauteed vegetables right here.
All into one bowl.
In one bowl. This is so simple. I've never seen such a simple salad. This is great.
And then the 3/4 cups of Orzo. Already.
Which we've pre-done ahead of time. And that's what it looks like.
Stir that together.
Stir that together really well. And you're going to actually refrigerate this.
Yes.
That's the cool part.
Nice summer salad, nice side
actually,
dish.
Actually, it's a nice salad anytime, actually.
It's fresh and beautiful and has just a teeny bit of a kick.
Yeah. Go ahead now. Now you're going to add all the lovely ingredients.
This is the lemon juice, the lemon zest, the thyme.
And that all goes
pepper.
Together. And then
how beautiful is that?
That is beautiful. And then you refrigerate that in your refrigerator, right? And then what we're going to do to make it simple is we are going to actually put it into the serving bowl and put it in the refrigerator so that when we actually serve it, it's all ready to go, right?
Yes. Perfect. Perfect.
Here we go. That looks so good. All right. And I absolutely loved it. I wouldn't pour it all. I'll just wait. Yeah. I'm pouring some of the...
I'm not pouring.
Yeah. Okay. Let me hear. I've got it. I love these kind of salads because they have just a little bit. Orzo is so beautiful. I love it. It's so tasty.
It's so dialysis friendly.
It is dialysis friendly. Everything we had today is dialysis friendly.
I love it. I love it.
Right. I know that my brother would have loved this dish. He would have loved it. And look how beautiful it is.
So gorgeous.
It is gorgeous. Well, we want you to see that, how pretty that is. And we're going to be serving that with the turkey wings, which are almost done.
And
the pork loin, which is almost done. We have our beautiful, you want to show that what we're going to put on the pork loin?
As your pork loin is finished, what we're going to do is we're going to just apply this glaze gently over the whole top of your pork loin, along the sides, and then put it back in the oven for just maybe another 6 to 8 minutes, just long enough for it to caramelize. It will make such a difference in your pork loin.
It really will. And, you know, we have these beautiful dessert that we're going to have with maybe just a tiny bit of ice cream.
Oh, just a tad.
Oh, just a tad. We want to thank everyone for helping us, especially the NxStage chef.
Oh, yes.
Who created all of these wonderful recipes for NxStage and dialysis patients. And, you know, we'll have a wonderful Thanksgiving dinner, but we want to give NxStage's website.
Yes.
So that's
www.nxstage, that's N-X, capital S-T-A-G-E, .com.
And the recipes are up there as well, but the recipes will also be up on The Chef You and I.
Yes.
So check that out. And when we come back, we'll be having dinner in the dining room.
Yes.
With turkey wings and wonderful pork loin with that great glaze on it.
Oh my goodness, so good.
And you know, I made some biscuits. But we didn't have time tonight to make them on the air, but you'll be able to see the biscuits and I'll have the recipe.
Yes.
Right.
We must share that.
We must share that. And what a wonderful, wonderful meal. Thank you. Enjoy it.
I really had a great time and I love to be able to show that we can
do things as a dialysis patient or for dialysis patients that you're doing. So we'll be right back right after these important messages. on The Chef You and I with my favorite new chef, Celeste Fuller, who is not only a patient consultant, but an NxStage
patient
advocate as well. And she was on hemodialysis and dialysis for many years. And her sweet husband, they're like newlyweds basically, right?
Yes,
Tony. And we made a meal that is so beautiful. The turkey wings, Tony, are I've never seen turkey wings quite like this before, right?
Right.
Right.
They're different.
They're different.
They're different.
And you want to show the orzo,
yes.
Those are vegetables. It's a medley of vegetables with orzo. Yes. Then we have the herb biscuits. And what we've done that's a little different for this show is that we've done a pork, right?
Yes.
With stuffed apple stuffing.
Yes.
And so you wouldn't necessarily eat the turkey and the pork, you know, but there's a lot of people that don't like turkey, right?
Right.
Absolutely.
Just change it up a little bit.
Mm-hmm. And we're going to have dessert in just a little while, but we'll show how we made the dessert. But we're at the end of our show, and this is our Thanksgiving meal. And I'm so happy to be here with you.
I'm thankful.
And you want to say a little grace?
Yes.
Because part of Thanksgiving is the grace part, right?
Absolutely.
Go ahead.
Lord, we just thank you for this day. We thank you for our health and our strength.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, we just thank you for the opportunity to gather together with friends and enjoy our dialysis-friendly meal, and be able to share with others that it's possible to still stay included with your family, and enjoy the meal and enjoy the holidays. We thank you for this opportunity. Amen.
Amen. And we hope that you have a wonderful Thanksgiving. This is a NxStage dialysis meal.
Yes.
And it's going to keep you healthy and happy. And we want to say bon appetit, all of you, and happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving.
And we'll see you next time on The Chef You and I.
Thanks for joining us on The Chef You and I show today. We'll be back next week with another great and healthy recipe. Don't forget to visit our website, thechefyouandi.com, for all of our featured recipes, cooking tips, and clips of the show.